This week on Sport Fishing, I'm down in Florida, and I'm going to be fishing with Bill Duffel, the guy standing next to me. Hey, Bill.
Hey, Dan.
Thanks for inviting me down. Yeah. Bill is the owner of Tough Coat, the covering for your boats, the paint. Really nice item. And what we're going to be doing today, I think, is fishing for tarpon.
We're going tarpon fishing. It's peak season down here in Marathon for tarpon, and we're going to go fish the Long Key Bridge, and hopefully we'll catch us two or three tarpon.
That'd be cool. I haven't caught tarpon in so long. And the only place I've ever caught tarpon, personally, is down in Central America. So to do it in North America up here and do it in Florida would be really neat.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be great.
Thanks for inviting me down.
You bet.
All right, so that's the plan today. We're going to go tarpon fishing. Hopefully, we're going to land a couple. You never know with tarpon. Just hooking one is a great achievement. But if you land it and get to the boat, that's like the cherry on top.
You bet. That's what we're praying for.
All right. So stay tuned for this week's exciting episode of Sport Fishing.
Hey, Dan, we're here in Marathon, Florida. We're fishing the Long Key Bridge. A lot of tarpon in the area right now. They're having great success. We can get closer to the bridge, or you can start fishing these channels. I like to fish the channels first and start working my way back to the bridge. What we're doing today, Dan, is we're fishing between these two little islands here, two little high spots. The tarpon like to get in these channels and wait for bait to come off the high spots. So we're kind of at a high tide right now, so we're waiting for the tide to kind of go out, and they'll sit here and they'll kind of ambush the bait.
So right now, as the tide's coming in, they're all facing into one direction?
Yes. And they feed when the tide is going in or out. When the tide is dead and slack, they don't feed nearly as much. So it doesn't matter what time of day it is, just as long as the tide's moving.
Okay, good. Well, hopefully we'll get one soon.
Yeah. You give the bait a twitch every now and then just to keep it from getting down in the grass. If not, it'll get down in the grass and the fish can't find it, they can't see it. You want it to stay up on the surface, stay active. Today we're using mullet. You want to use a nice, lively bait. Take and hook them through the nose, just like that.
Why do you like the circle hook so much?
Like the circle hook because it gets down in the soft of their mouth on the corner, and you don't really have to set it. It sets itself. Tarpon have a real hard mouth, so if you don't use a circle hook, you really got to set that hook, and you're hoping it grabs.
And once we hook one, it's been a long time since I've hooked a tarpon. Is there anything particular I need to do, or?
Well, once you hook one, the other fisherman rolls his reel in as fast as he can. You pop the anchor. The anchor is on a buoy system where you just let the anchor go and stay there, and then you follow the tarpon. You start the boat and you follow it. You're not going to sit on a boat and in one spot and reel in a tarpon.
I just saw a tarpon jump under the bridge.
Yeah, they're rolling all through here.
Yeah, but that is.
We had a fish blowing up on the bait. I let him take it, and it instantly sheared it off, so we're thinking it was a shark or a good-sized barracuda. So I gotta rehook.
He's right here. I got him, relax. Don't chase him so fast. All right. Got a tarpon going here. That's what we came for, got a tarpon. My first Florida tarpon. He's right here. I got him right here. It's all right. He's going left. He's going to the boat. Change your battery out. There we go. Here's right here. He's gonna jump. Come on, tarpon. Bridge will make it more fun. There he comes. Oh, right there. He's running. Man, hold on. He's running. He's going out that way.
That's where we want him. That's where we want him.
Yeah, in deeper water.
Yeah. Reel, reel, reel. There he is. You got to keep tight. Bow to the king, baby. He's got to come up. He's got to breathe.
Come on, tarpon. He comes up to the surface again.
Yep.
He's right here at the boat.
Once he, the reason they jump, Dan, they know the boat's up on him, they'll jump. That's so we can make him jump. No, serious. When you get close to him, they'll want to jump.
Okay, don't. You're going to run over him. Stop. You're going to run over him.
Okay.
He's right here.
It's just a little one.
Yeah, he's a little one.
It's only 120 pounds.
He's going to jump right here. Making a run. Here he comes, right to the surface, right here. Here he comes. Yeah!
Did you get that?
Woo!
Nice.
Just leave the boat here. I want to pull him to the boat. We'll keep him out of there. We won't let him get to the bridge. Right here, coming to the surface again.
I tell you what, those mustache hooks are sharp.
Sharp hooks.
Sharp hooks. Probably got right in the corner of his mouth.
Circle hook.
And you know, you're getting traction with a tough coat under your feet.
What's really cool about this fish, we fished this one spot for an hour and a half, didn't get any bites. We looked over on the other side of the other bridge, and we saw a couple of tarpon roll. So Bill said, let's move the boat over there. We've anchored the boat. And within 2 minutes, we hooked up. So hopefully this is one of those fish. They must have just been cruising on the other bridge.
Get some line on him.
Yeah, he's not very
far
away.
Good job, buddy.
He's right there on the surface.
Oh, yeah.
Here he comes, right here at the surface. Right here. Put that in neutral.
I'm in neutral.
He's gonna jump right here. Here he goes.
He's going to the bridge. I'm going a little bit forward, Dan. So in case he gets to the bridge, I'm gonna be close to him, all right? So you know.
Relax. We got him.
Ooh, tarpon fishing, baby. He goes under, we want to stay close.
Okay.
So you know, I'll do my best to keep you in neutral when I need to be.
Okay.
Just communicate with me.
He's right here, right under the boat. I can see him.
I'm in neutral.
Okay. See which way he wants to go. See a low color. Now he's gone this way.
Yeah, they'll.
I just want to get that underwater, so.
He'll be up to the side here. Is he going under?
No, he's right here. He's in the center of the bridge.
Okay.
Okay,
understand, I gotta keep
we gotta go this way now. Turn the bridge.
I gotta keep my boat off the bridge too.
Okay, straight ahead.
Go ahead, reel up.
Straight ahead. Where we don't want to be under the bridge, but here we are.
The fish is gonna come up in a minute.
He's right here. Okay, neutral.
I am.
It's right under the boat.
I gotta watch the wind and everything else, so you know. Do my best. I'm going this way because my boat's gonna hit over here.
Okay.
Just letting you know. He's going back out.
Braid line in the reel now. Okay. One disaster averted. There's leader. There's my leader.
All right, Dan, we're following him now. We got to keep him out of the bridge.
Okay.
So we're going to do our best. We got wind, we got current, we got a fish that wants to cut you off.
Yeah,
so we're
going
to do our best to keep you from getting cut off.
I'm surprised we got him back from that color. He's coming up.
Oh, you'll
jump.
Get color.
He's
going
to jump right now.
This fish is only half wore out, guys. We got Captain Dan Hernandez.
There he is,
on
right
the pole,
right
baby.
There.
But we need to. I'm going to angle outward, Dan.
Okay.
Okay.
He's coming into his stern.
Got him. Okay, I'll slow down. I'm in neutral.
He's going to jump right here again, it looks like. Make a little roll.
Give him some tension. There you go.
Taking line.
Yeah, I know. You got him. Perfect.
There he comes right here. There he comes.
Right, all right, reel down. Let's go get him. If he goes towards the bridge, we got to stay on him tight.
Okay. He already tried that once.
Good thing I put that Lucas oil in my engine. You got to run it out of gas to kill it.
Hey, we got an audience now. We got two boats following us. Here he goes. He's going to jump. Here he comes. There he is.
Did you get that? Oh, he missed it. Right here. He's coming up. He should be over here. All Scott's thinking is, yeah, I'm out of here.
There he is. He's on the surface. There he is. There he is.
He's on the surface.
He's on the surface. There he goes.
Dan looks like he's got this thing about wore out, but they still get a little fight in him, and he gets underneath that bridge. We're still in trouble, but he's doing a great job. He's pumping when he needs to, giving it drag when he needs to.
There he is, right on the surface.
Dan's just about got him wore out. He's just a little one. He's about 8-9 pounds. No, he's a 100-pounder.
Yeah, probably 100 pounds.
Yeah, nice,
not
nice
as big
fit.
As my shark. But this is what we came for. This was the goal, was to catch a tarpon. We already got him to leader twice. We're trying to get him all the way to the boat.
Neutral?
Yeah.
Get some, get some, get some. Any chance you got to get anything on these fish, you take it.
Here he comes, there's the leader, he's right on the surface. He's right here next to the boat. Here he is, right here. Here he is, right there.
Get over there, Kev.
Beautiful.
Get a shot of that, Kev. I'm gonna need you to drive the boat in a minute. Because I'm going to pull this fish out, and I'm going to need you to keep me out of the bridge when we land him. We had him to the boat. What happened?
Yeah, he wanted to make a run. It's a 30-minute program, so we have to stretch it out a little bit. Hey, Bill, I just want to thank you, man. This is one of those bucket wish items on my list.
We're here.
You know, to come fish in the Keys and catch a tarpon. I've caught tarpon in Nicaragua and Costa Rica. Never had the opportunity to fish here in Florida for one, and I got one now.
All right, let's land him, baby.
There he is, right here on the surface.
Right here, Kev, over here. All right, Dan, see if we can get him.
He's right here.
Bring him side of the boat here. I'll try. I got my gloves on.
Okay.
See if we can get him.
Here he comes.
When I go down to pick this fish up, Kevin, you got to take the helm.
This side, right here. There he goes the other side now. I think he's gonna jump for us right here. Here he comes, the surface.
Here he goes.
There he goes, right there, right there. Keep his head turning to the boat.
Not ready.
Here he goes.
Oh, he's not ready.
Does he know we're gonna let him go?
Yeah, as long as he's going that way, let him freaking, it'll wear him out. Tension on him, it'll wear him out. Keep him tight. As long as he's going away, that's what we want. He's going into the bay, Bay of Florida.
Okay, he's right here.
That propeller. Sure, you see that every time you go around it, you're thinking, I don't want to hit that prop. All right, get some.
He's right here, I can see him.
Do you? All right.
He's right on the bow. Right. Matt Leader, he's right here. Here he is. Here he is. I think he's ready now.
Bring him over. Go ahead and go in.
He was ready. There he is, on the surface.
Bring him over. I'm gonna grab Leader.
Oh, it busted off. Right there.
Woo!
Woo! That was a great fish. Got him to Leader twice. That's what we wanted to do. We were fishing a tournament, hook and release that we count. Had him right there, pulled on a little too hard. But that's what we wanted to do. Come here, come to Florida. And Bill was nice enough to invite us down. That was awesome.
Woo! Cut that with his gill plate.
Yeah.
They have a really sharp gill plate. And if they turn just in the wrong way, they cut it with that gill plate. That's why you use 80 pound test. Hey, we got Leader.
We got him.
That's a landed fish.
Yeah, that was cool. All right, we're gonna take a little break from the action here in Marathon, Florida. And when we return, I'll be giving you this week's tip of the week. Woo!
Yeah!